This next lady is hilarious. Make some noise for Meryl Davis.
Thank you, hi. So, I was peed upon recently. I know that's not a proper grammatical term, but I was peed upon. And I feel like I've experienced that fetish now from at least one angle. So, you know, I felt the warm urine and the humiliation. So I'm good. I don't think I need to experience that again. But he marked me, so now we're dating. So, just a Doberman. He's really masculine. And it's kind of scary, but it's hot, you know? So I saw my ex recently. I know that's a terrible idea. It's a really bad idea. I saw him for an equally terrible reason, because I think I still love him. So it's bad. You know, it's like dumb. It's love is dumb. Anyway, I think he's a pathological liar. I asked him. He said he's not, but I don't know if I believe him. So, but we're going to discuss it when he gets back from the International Space Station. So funny, every time he comes back from space, he smells like perfume. I'm not a scientist, but shouldn't he smell like space? Just think, we don't know what that smells like, you know what I mean? I mean, we're in space, technically, but... I got a weird birthday gift recently from my mom, and she sent me a sign that says forgive. You know, like a sign to hang up. So I sent her a sign that says please apologize first. It's like the most passive-aggressive apology I've ever received. Like, everything will be fine. I'm like, should I send you a list? Do you forget what happened? Do you remember the past, or did you just black it out? I guess it's always best to just black it completely. I had a day job, and I had to get up at 5 in the morning, so that was a perk. And so it was a tough job, and so I had a mantra that I used to get through it all the time, which was, there's no I in team, but there is an I, and I can't do this. So that was my mantra. Okay. So I have a lot of anxiety. I don't know if you can tell. It's all natural. Thank you. I don't really do anything for it. I've thought about it a lot. I really think there's only one real cure for anxiety, and I think that's death. So I don't want to die. I just feel like I'll be really calm, you know. I just feel like I'll be calm. And I think it's because I come from a mixed background. I don't know if you can tell. I'm a Southern Baptist Jew. So we had a menorah, but we also got beaten with it. So we were really bad. They left the candles lit. So they really covered all the bases. But before the job, I had technically I still have that job, but we don't have to talk about that. Before that, I had a nanny job, and I worked for this kid directly. The parents weren't involved, and he was kind of a mean kid, you know? Like, basically, he was too young to drive, so he was too old to need a nanny, so it was just like, he just needed a buddy to, like, hang out with. And I would pick him up from school and drive him around and stuff like that. And then we would, like, play Call of Duty Black Ops. Are you familiar with this very violent video game? Yeah, you guys are really into it. It really triggered my anxiety. And so it was a lot of fun. I didn't know how to play, so I was like, just show me how to play. It would be really... And so he showed me how. Like, he told me to pause my character, and then he stabbed me with his character. So that was our relationship in a nutshell. So then I would pick him up from school, and he would say things to try to get my goat, you know? I mean, I don't have a goat, but no one says that anymore. But he was like, what do you hate more, black people who act white or white people who act black? And I was like, ooh, I hate 12-year-olds who are racist. I was like, what is wrong with you? And he was like, I'm not a good person. And I was like, you're not a person. Like, you just got here, like, 5 minutes ago. How did you figure that out? So then I drove him down to Englewood, and I rolled down the window, and I had him repeat the question. So I don't know how the rest of his life will go, but I tried to help. So I'm not the mom. Anyway, so yeah, I have a lot of anxiety, as I mentioned. And my mom, she's a very interesting character. She's like a very dramatic person all the time. Like, she just recently sent me an email that she ended with, "Just trying to stay alive, Mom," which was better than her last email, which was, "I'm dead, Mom." No, she's not dying. She's just very dramatic about everything. And so recently, my ex, not the space station one, another one, didn't want to be friends. And so I was very upset. And she gives a lot of very vague, sort of cliched advice in those moments. So I called her. I was like, "Mom, I'm really upset. Greg doesn't want to be friends." And she said, "Meryl, there are no absolutes." And I was like, "Does that mean we're out of vodka? Like, what does that mean?" And then she said, "One thing is for sure, nothing is for sure." And then she said, "There's no business like show business." And I was like, "Are you a cliche robot? Like, what's happening?" And then she was like, "Where's the beef?" And I was like, "That's an ad from the 80s. You're not helping at all." And then she was like, "Just do it. Just kill yourself." It's like a new Nike ad. It's very pro-suicide. It's very, very dark, obviously. But anyway, I do a lot of dumb things. I don't consider myself a dumb person, but I do dumb things sometimes. I was getting off the phone with the cable guy the other day, and I was like, "Love you, bye." And he didn't respond, but I called him back, and I was like, "I don't love you. I mean, I don't know you. Let's go out and see." No, but he was like, "I'm in India, and these calls are timed," so he hung up. So that relationship's thriving. No, and then I saw a billboard recently by Kaiser Permanente that I read as "Deafy diabetes." Like, you definitely have diabetes. Or like the lady with the swimming goggles on the poster, "Deafy has." I was like, okay, I guess we're just gonna talk like this now. Like, the doctor's just gonna walk in and be like, "OMG, it's totes lymphoma," and then walk out. Deafy AIDSies, but it was, it's Defy Diabetes, and I'm blind, and my ex, who was with me at the time, he's a very intelligent individual, so he's definitely not gonna marry me, so yeah. I'm selling CDs in case anybody's interested. Things are going great for me right now. They're not my comedy CD, they're just used CDs that I'm selling. I've got like some Depeche Mode, some Hits the 90s, some Cranberries, you know. Don't Let It Linger, because I really need your support. I had a really fun time tonight. Thank you so much.